Huh, look at that.
You gotta wait to get another Keyblade.
Well then.
We got a Mithril Stone too. Mithril's gonna suck to find later in the game. Now, all the blue abilities here are unique to Valor. High Jump level 1 is its growth ability. If you level up Sora enough, if you level up Valor Form enough, High Jump will increase in its power, and Sora will get the last one as its own ability.
Yes.
Sync Blade allows you to get two Keyblades. Now, the support abilities differ. Some of them are unique to the forms, but most of them are what Sora has equipped as his support abilities. Like Combo Boost? I think Combo Boost. Yeah, Combo Boost I think is unique for, will be on Valor as long as Sora has it equipped. The weapons, he gets two abilities depending on what his Keyblades have. I have Damage Control and Air Combo Plus, so there's that, pretty much solving that problem. Valor levels up depending upon how many whacks you give, how many times you boop an enemy in the noggin with it.
Ideal for boss fights if you want to level up.
Yes and no.
I find
it's good for boss battles, yeah. Organization 13 battles, dry forms are limited. Oops.
Hey, we dropped our key.
The car keys. And here's a new mechanic for Final Mix.
Huh.
These are called puzzle pieces.
It's part of a picture? Yeah, it looks like a glowing crown to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, seriously. No, it doesn't.
Or if someone slipped me a Mickey.
Oh, God. I would say why I'm out of it for 3 years. Basically, what this is puzzles. You solve the puzzles, you get new items. There are six, I think there's like three or, was it five or six puzzles in total? The later puzzles get really fucking nice items, though. One of them is a ring that gives you 30 AP, and the other is a Grand Ribbon, which gives you a whopping, a nice buff in all of your defensive stats. I like to go to puzzle mode immediately as soon as I get one and try to solve them immediately as I can there and there and go along with it.
That's your wall scroll.
Yeah. Essentially.
You're cheating.
No, like, Elliot does bring up the good point, though. Basically, all of it is just basically concept art from the... Not concept art. Like, artworks.
Promotional
images,
material.
See promoted for the game. Promotional images. Thank you.
There. All right, but ladies and gentlemen, our adventure for Kingdom Hearts 2 is now finally getting appropriately started.
4 hours later.
4 hours, the tutorial later. You would think they learned from this and not do it again, but Final Fantasy 13 gives you about 20 hours.
Goddamn.
What happened to all of our sweet perks?
Yeah, what happened to Johnny's gummy ship? That's it, rocked. You had to start over from the beginning to learn anew.
Bullshit, that shit's in your garage right now, isn't it?
He chop shopped it.
Oh, fuck. That suit wasn't free, Sora.
I'll take that as my payment.
The worlds have returned to their original states. That means the pathways between them have disappeared.
What about Deep Jungle? Deep what?
Do not fear.
What about Neverland?
Never who?
True.
Shit.
The worlds have prepared new pathways along which you may travel.
Oh, so we really had nothing to worry about.
So what's the fucking point of scaring me?
Yeah.
Special gates.
Ow, my leg.
How these gates are opened.
Got me a little grumpy there.
I do not know. However, the Keyblade will serve as your guide.
It's a Keyblade GPS now? It's just like a fucking metal detector just for worlds.
The Keyblade's primary purpose is the GPS. Secondary is,
It also has a signal flare.
He's... But they all forgot about me. Oops.
That is correct.
I do like that Yen Sid, despite his serious voice, does smile and nod like he reacts like a rubber human being.
Well, he could do without the beady eyes.
Oh, you're smart.
You know, he's just like one color away from his eyes to be Judge Doom from Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Oh, God. Wait, did you say Roger Rabbit?
Roger Rabbit.
Roger Rabbit.
Roger, comma, Robin.
Who Framed Rockin' Robin?
That it's not, Donald.
Now then, that is all the information I can give to you. Go for
apparently that's all he knows for now.
Donald and Goofy.
Five.
Everyone they want to keep counting.
Okay, let's get going.
Master Yensid, we sure do appreciate the help.
Oh, yo.
Don't tell me he's a nobody, too.
Yeah.
Oh, God damn it.
It was secretly Disney the entire time.
The fools.
My goodness, what's that?
Uh-oh.
Ah, shit.
That's a cloak with a crow. Watch out!
It'll cover you.
And here's how we could have avoided this one bit.
Haven't we seen this somewhere before?
No.
Yes, dear. I wonder whose it was. Oh, Maleva! No, we mustn't remember her name. Oh, dear.
She who shall not be named.
Technically, Maleficent's a dark fairy.
The memories are coming back. What'll we do? Oh, what'll we do?
So wait, she only said half of her name, though. So, will she come back?
But see, here's the thing. The way that this scene is carrying out, I honestly think that Maleficent was just returning the power to begin with, and the name calling is just a formality.
Yeah. Well, no, like I said before, like as some sort of joke. She only said half of her name. She'd come back as a dwarf.
Right.
Or, you know. She'd come back with her arms with no legs. Oh, you had to...
Sure. You bitch! I would love that if the robot popped in to cap the blue one. What did I just say? But she was already coming back. No point, honey.
You know what someone should do? Photoshop her face instead of her. It's Angelina Jolie.
What were you saying, Matt?
One of the problems I have with Kingdom Hearts 2's plot, and we'll delve into it more as we go along, is when it comes to the worlds themselves, the players and the set pieces and actors are all fine and dandy. Barring maybe Olympus Coliseum. Overall, the main plot focus, like if we were to do plot A, like, you know, Sword, Donald Goofy, and Nobody's.
Yeah.
There's quite a lot of set players there in that thing, and not everybody gets utilized fully, so you end up with some wasted characters. Or wasted opportunity and potential. So I don't think Kingdom Hearts 2 is a really bad story. I do think, however, it doesn't fully live up to its potential. And I think it's because you got too many cooks in plot A, and it's like... what's that saying? Too many cooks spoil the broth?
Too many cooks. Yeah, it's something like that. I know what you mean.
It's too many ingredients spoil the recipe or something like
no,
that.
No, but I think it's like too many cooks in the kitchen spoil
right.
the broth. Yeah,
but and that's what happens. You got like too many cooks in the kitchen, so to speak.
But it takes a lot to make a stew.
No, it takes a...
you know what I'm talking about. So,
anyway.
I'm going to find a safe point. We're going to call this a session.
Yes, indeedy we do.
We're going to Hollow
Bastion,
though.
The only thing, the only real problem I have with Kingdom Hearts 2, and this also... extends to one. I think we may have said a similar complaint. Is it likened to the main overarching story seems to stall every time we go to a Disney World? You know, because our main goal right now is to stop Organization 13. But most of the time, we find ourselves sidetracked to play what's pretty much an abridged version of a Disney story.
Well, there's two things. One, that's always just going to be a thing we're going to have to deal with, considering that's the whole point of Kingdom Hearts. But the thing is that Organization 13 is running rampant in the other worlds, too. So basically, our journey is the first time around with the worlds is to find out what happens in the story worlds, but then the other times is sniffing out the organization.
This is loading.
Yeah, that's one problem the 2.5 HD remaster has. The loading times are a bit more... Ow.
Yeah. Googles.
You were doing Luya made out big.
Hey, you know, Hollow Bastion looks a little better.
Yeah, you know, last time we were here, we only saw the city. Now we're actually seeing the city proper.
You see the castle out in the distance.
It looks like they're in the middle of reconstruction, it seems.
It's Hollow Bastion.
What a dreadful name.
She looks kind of different now.
Oh yeah, Leon.
What's wrong, Sora? You guys creeped out by fire? No, why? Maybe it's just me.
My imagination. Wow, Kingdom Hearts still ain't fucking around. First world's Hollow Bastion.
Yeah. I love this track, though.
It's a great track, too, I think, as well. It takes away some... I like 1's Hollow Bastion more, admittedly.
I do, too.
But 2's theme is good for what it's trying to convey. It sets up rebuilding after what happened in the first world.
Hey, you got a puzzle piece.
So it's not quite as... It's not quite as energetic as the first one, so to speak. But yes, I did get a puzzle piece. Thank you, Elliot.
The original Hollow Bastion theme had a sense of menace.
It had a sense of menace and a sense of urgency at the same time, but we don't have that this time around, because it's not like... It does have a darkness problem. It's not like, you know, that's the sole focus of it. Right now, we're focusing on both that and the rebuilding.
Yes.
So, it's not... It doesn't really need, like, the rapid pace and the battle... The rapid pace and the threat of impending battle, you know? At least that's what I think.
A hammer staff?
Yeah, this time around, they don't really, like, do that whole thing with Donald and Goofy, where it's like, plus this, minus this. Goofy still has some degree of it, but more often than not, Goofy's just, whatever shield you fire for Goofy's gonna be better than what he already had.
So who do we expect to see here in Hollow Bastion now?
Moogles.
Other than Moogles. And Huey, Dewey, and Louie.
Other than Moogles, who else do you need?
Exactly. Synthesis is big in the HD remaster.
Yes, it is.
I mean, it's really big. Like, you're going to be doing this shit a lot. Huey, Dewey, and Louie are pretty much your item shop, your weapons, and your armor shops. Meanwhile, we get Uncle Scrooge.
Scrooge McDuck.
Scrooge McDuck.
I think it's the same guy voicing him, too.
Yes, it is. And that guy is in his 90s.
He's been voicing Scrooge McDuck since the beginning.
I can't. One of the few that's been handpicked by Walt Disney himself.
A business tycoon.
Tycoon.
No, Goofy said typhoon.
Not, that's not too far-fetched, Matt, considering how old this guy is.
Seriously, no, I'm not kidding. Like, there are a few characters, like Pat Carroll. Some of them were handpicked by Walt Disney himself to voice the roles and act.
Well, when did Walt Disney pass? It was...
Kyrie's grandmother was one of them. She gave an underwhelming performance in this game. Birth by Sleep knocks her right out the... She knocks her out the park.
No, you know, because the way you make it... Oh, no. I don't think...
I own a killing hearty. I love Scrooge McDuck as a character. Like, he's a greedy sort like Donald, but with all that agent experience behind his back, he knows exactly how to apply greed properly and stuff. Apply greed properly. How do I put it? Like, he has this motto where he never trusts a dollar he doesn't earn. And that applies to his business sets like that, too. Like, he realizes that there's more to the riches than money. Like, he finds himself enjoying more personal riches, the sense of adventure and exploration.
I mean, look at DuckTales.
Woo! Damn it, Jinx! I still haven't had a save point yet, so we're going to have to
wait tonight. Nope. We're still going.
That's new.
That's very much new.
But that's not going to hurt you. It's pretty much a test defense mechanism.
Okay.
You said it first.
Oh, hey, Yuffie.
Rocking her Advent Children attire, if I believe remember.
I do like that attire.
I do like that attire on her, admittedly, yes. And it makes sense. Makes more sense to me than the fucking arm gauntlet.
She was originally supposed to be Riku in the original Kingdom Hearts. And it showed in her design.
Yeah.
But now it's properly Yuffie attire.
I actually do like Tifa's new attire as well.
Well, all the Final Fantasy VII characters, except Sid.
He's still rocking his Kingdom Hearts 1 attire. Yeah.
Which I kind of found a little lazy. Not gonna lie.
The hell?
Oh! I didn't pay attention. Oh. That was the samurai that caught me. I wasn't paying attention, so that was my fault. Basically, if you block blows with a samurai, you'll get a command prompt coming up to them called, which is dual stance. Ow.
Oh, you.
Need help? Yeah! I see you're still in top
form. Apparently Donald offed it. Looks like you're doing okay.
Well, what did you expect? I want the others. She has a different voice actress too, doesn't she?
Hey,
Christy Cross and Romana.
Nope. But I had a feeling I'd see you guys again.
By the way, what the fuck is up with that fucking broken belt for her design? We'll never meet
again. Where? But we'll never her belt's broken.
Is that supposed to be it Leon? Is.
You smell.
Is that supposed to be Leon? Kind of sucks.
So wait, that's actually Kim Possible?
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you for giving us this map that we kind of don't need for now.
I keep finding them on the floor. Anyway, the dual stance reaction command.
Basically, you get blocked into a little thing with the nobody, and if you and you get four choices, your command slots.
Yeah.
If you land on the end, you'll do major damage to the samurai. Fuck it up and he hits you, and you take major damage.
Yeah.
I wasn't paying attention during the fight. I honestly hardly was expecting a dual stance there, but, I'm a dumbass.
It is something to watch out for.
Right.
If you decide to go into the stance in the first place. Alright, showing off your Valor form a little early.
Yeah, why not? I got time.
Oh, damn.
Alright, this
you
is
just
the Valor
pretty much
form.
Bits the fuck out of everybody.
This costs Goofy.
Yeah, this costs Goofy?
Yes.
Really?
Transmission price, one Goofy. So, yeah, basically, you can't have Goofy in this form. Your other restrictions are you have no defensive game. So, basically, your offense has to be really good. And you can't heal with magic. You gotta use items only for healing, which isn't so much of a drawback later on.
No, can you turn off the Valor form, like, at will?
Yes, you can, but it takes away all your drive gauge, so you may as well just use it.
Yeah, use it while you can. That's what the revert thing on the icon is for, Elliot.
Remember, there's also one other thing. Elliot, I'm grateful you brought that up. They fixed the drive form's growth. Like, you can, it comes back much quicker now than it did before. Like, I want to say, like, super-duper quick, but, compared to how... But I could notice a notable improvement in terms of drive gauge game between this game and the original.
Yeah.
Two puzzle pieces.
So that I don't, like... So that, you know, you're never really at zero or minus gauge for very long. Drive recoveries were also changed, too. In the original, that single item only restored one drive gauge. In Final Mix, it's three.
So nearly the entire thing.
They really want you to utilize drive forms in Final Mix.
Yes, because the puzzle pieces, the Cavern of Remembrance, and a few other things are all going to require your drive form. So you may as well get a use out of them now. You know, I can't reach that because I lack the proper ability.
Really?
Yeah, I tried as much. I tried approaching that from all angles. It is impossible with Sora's current equipment.
Well, damn.
If there is, you're a speedrunner or a hack.
Shit,
you're a hack.
Mister, I can get that puzzle piece early.
AP boosts. Again, very helpful. All go to Sora. Considering that now they've reorganized some of the treasures around, you don't quite have as many AP boosts as you would have in the first in vanilla Kingdom Hearts 2. So let's head into the hut.
I will admit that dry forms in my very, very first playthrough of Kingdom Hearts 2 were something I didn't really emphasize a lot.
I didn't either until I realized I had to go until I needed them to be maxed out for the paradox. So I was like, "Fuck!"
No, I utilized them the moment I found out that's how I get my high jumps and glides.
Right?
Like, oh shit! We
missed you. So wait, Aerith, Cid, and Leon are still in there in the same attire?
Yeah. Aerith is a really bad performance. It's Mina Suvari's last role, and it feels like they recorded her conversation through a Skype call. She is completely disinterested in the role.
Leon has the fluff collar from 8 now.
Right. Leon's more tuned with his 8 design. In fact, his face looks more like an 8 design than his Kingdom Hearts design. Like, I'm sorry. It's like I look at Leon in this game, and I look at Leon in Kingdom Hearts 1, and they look completely different.
Yeah. But again, but I do like the added, like, his design is closer to 8. I
kind of appreciate that, but I kind of really grew attached to Leon from, I really grew more attached to Leon from,
Kingdom Hearts 1
design. That looked really cool with the long hair. It was a really unique take on the character.
Well, he still has long hair, doesn't he?
No, this is short hair.
Does he?
Okay. Yeah, okay. He looks way more like his 8 reincarnation than he did the 25-year-old biker.
It's still pretty long.
Yeah, it's
still not 8 short.
It's pretty there.
Yeah.
If I were to look at him from his back, you'll notice the difference.
Yeah, well, we can get a better angle at that later. But I'm glad to see... Well, actually, not glad to see. I'm being completely sarcastic here. They still have those 3 belt buckles on his left arm for no fucking reason.
That makes no sense.
Yeah, it's so long.
Oh,
it
is long. You're right. Donald,
Goofy, we were hoping the three of you might
give us a hand around here. Fuck me, wrong. Like we're gonna say no? But, not today, we aren't. I forgot who I'm
dealing with. Oh, you went to Castle Oblivion too?
Just think of it as what Castle Oblivion? We don't remember Castle Oblivion.
Yeah, it was Mandy Moore who voiced Aerith in Kingdom Hearts 1. This one,
no, I'm pretty sure it was Mark Romano. There's something you need
to see. No, in Kingdom Hearts 1, it was Mandy Moore who voiced Aerith. This is her advent.
Oh, Aerith!
Yeah, Aerith.
Yeah. Mandy Moore was Kingdom Hearts 1. Mina Suvari was Kingdom Hearts 2.
Yeah. That's her advent children voice actress.
Completely boring.
She sounds like...
She sounds like she was woken up to do this.
Yes.
Hey, it's 8 a.m. Are you ready?
You know what? Anybody can be a... Anybody can voice act as if you're given proper direction.
That's what I was saying way back when. You need good direction or else you don't know what to do with your voice actors.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying. Like, that's what I said like quite a few Let's Plays ago, actually. The city, Kuja was bad in the first one because the voice, they said, this is what Kuja is, try to emulate what you think he would sound like, and the voice actor was like, what the Christ.
You know what, and
they gave him better direction in Kingdom Hearts, in the city of Duodecim, and Kuja was much better in that game.
I always thought that Steve Burton was a good choice for Cloud in terms of voice, but his direction was absolute shit.
Right, that's
and
the
I
problem.
Think the biggest offender of that is... Now, I would say so much Kingdom Hearts series, but Dissidia, definitely.
Yeah.
He sounds so fucking bored in that game.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what they tried to have him sound like. I'm like, this ain't Cloud. The one thing they...
He's not my Cloud.
But you know who really knocks it out the park? George Newbern. Sephiroth.
Fucking
I can't imagine
Superman.
Anybody else voicing Sephiroth now.
Wait, what?
It's George Newbern. He was the voice of Superman in Justice League Unlimited.
Right.
It was Tim Daly in... the animated series, and I think the first part of Justice League, but it was George Newbern later on.
Right.
Who does a really good job, but yeah, I found that after the fact. I was like, that's fucking Superman.
That's some shit, ain't it?
Yeah.
Well, he is a Superman, and a Super Boss.
Yeah.
We now have magic again.
What do we got?
So when your MP is empty, it'll be recharged until it's full. Basically, your game automatically sets your MP charge for you, so don't even bother with that. Abilities that also consume MP will trigger the MP charge as well. So basically, we're going to customize Sora here for Blizzard, and it's already been done for me. Thank you very much.
Okay.
That's kind of it for that, at least. And there's another puzzle piece.
Yoink, I hope this wasn't Leon's.
All right.
I like how you used that knockback there to get the extra height you needed.
Hey, it works.
I'm an innovative sort. You also have a list of pieces. That also grows depending on what part of the world you're in. There's...
Other way. Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. Oh, that's different.
Yeah, that is different, actually.
Because on the wall scroll, it shows Riku and Kairi. On there, it's Donald and Goofy.
Huh.
Oh.
That's weird.
Okay, so
it's actually kind of a missed opportunity for the wall scroll.
Yeah.
All right, let's call it a session.
That we will. Next time we meet up, guys, we're going to go follow Leon, who's going to be probably wondering what we're going to be doing the whole week.
And then we find out, oh, he's killing zombies. He bleached his hair.
See you guys then.